Hello, everybody. You can't see me today, and that's for a good reason. You know, this coming Sunday is Pentecost, the descent of the Holy Spirit upon the apostles and the Blessed Mother who were gathered in prayer. A symbol of Pentecost is usually fire, tongues of flame, because the Gospels tell us that the Holy Spirit descended like tongues of flame over the heads of each of the apostles in prayer. And that's a good image, because what does fire do? It gives light and it gives warmth, and sometimes it burns away debris and rubbish that blocks us from the true source of things. But look also at another image of the Holy Spirit, and that image is that of water, an unseen source, a spring that comes up from we don't know where to go out and refresh the world and to bring refreshment and life. We can't live without water, and the Holy Spirit is the water that gives us life as Christians. Look at this fountain we have in front of our church, and it symbolizes that. You can see the water bubbling up from the top, but we don't know where it comes from. Look at the four pillars. They represent the four Gospels, each one with a different size, each one going in a different direction, but all of them issuing water to nourish and to give life to the world. And that's what the Holy Spirit does. As the Gospels go out to the world to nourish the world, so does the water from this fountain go out and provide nourishment, as the Gospels do. So this is just another symbol of the Holy Spirit. As we celebrate Pentecost Sunday this weekend, remember that in your lives, that the Holy Spirit illumines us, guides us, gives us warmth, burns away the debris that keeps us from understanding Christ in our lives more, but also is water, springing up from an unseen source and refreshing the world in all directions through the proclamation of the good news, which is the Gospel. Okay? Bye-bye.